Hello and welcome to another episode of I'm Setsuna. The last time we did this, we got more information on Julianne's illness and how she got it. Apparently, she drank a little of a monster to be able to survive. One day when she was trapped by like an avalanche or whatever, and that monster blood started corrupting her, even though she did live and get a lot of power from it, turns out that it's not always as good as it seems, and you can end up turning into a monster yourself, pretty much. So we had to talk to Sayagi the healer, because she seemed like she'd have the most information on how we'd be able to help her, and she told us that we'd have to use this special Sprint Knight magic thing, and to be able to power it up and bring out, you know, its true power, she had to spam lightning on us, on Setsuna, actually, to be able to take it, and Setsuna was supposed to keep curing herself and survive that barrage of lightning attacks. So, here we are. That's pretty much what it is. Here we are now. So, we're gonna go check on Julianne right now and see if we can save her. I feel like we're gonna have to fight her and knock her out, because the seal's more than likely broken. She's gonna attack us, we're gonna be like, whoa, no, don't do it. But how are all of you doing? I hope you're doing amazing well and good things are coming your way. Yeah, what's going on? Your Highness, please. Please endure for just a little longer. Everyone, please get back. Lady Setsuna, you have some sort of plan? I don't think that's back enough. When I give the signal, please remove the spell that's binding her. Very well. Now! Just face plants. Setsuna, are you alright? Setsuna! Lady Julianne, please be strong. I see. So you all. If you want to thank someone, thank Setsuna. She's the one who saved you. I see. Julianne, you're alright. Thank you, Setsuna. Alright! She's back! Hooray! She's back. Our Lady Julianne. Her Highness has returned. Hooray! Three cheers for the princess! Come, all of you. I understand how you feel, but please, quiet down. Quiet down. Does the monster blood seem to have left your body now, Your Highness? Most likely, it has not left entirely. But I shall no longer let it rule me. I can control it with my own strength. I know that much. Do you remember anything? All I remember is a world of perpetual, all-consuming darkness. A feeling of intense loneliness and of rage towards others. These emotions took control of my mind, spurring me on towards destruction. Whether they were my own emotions, or a result of some other influence, I do not know. At the same time, far away in the distance, I could hear a voice. Yes, a voice. A sad voice. I know not if it was the voice of a man or a monster, but the sorrow behind it tore at my heart. Each time I heard it, it seemed to eat away at my soul, and I was unable to fight back. Julian. You have fought bravely. This old man knows it well, as do all the knights. I thought that my duty to restore my homeland was the only thing that kept me going. But really, there was something else, huh? Indeed, Triple. It is exactly as you say. It is you, the knighthood, who truly keep me going. You, and all the people of the village who believe in me. I apologize for having worried all of you so. I know it is a lot to ask, but will you continue to lend me your support? Our hearts are with you, Your Highness. They always have been, and always shall be. There are none among us who have lost even an ounce of faith in you. Thank you, Cornelius. I intend to see this journey through so that our homeland may finally be restored. Together with my saviors, I shall see the last lands for myself. I shall learn the truth behind the old kingdom. O Royal Gate, in the name of my forefathers, I command that you open. In my veins flows royal blood, for it is I, Julian, the last true successor to the kingdom. Oh, so we wouldn't have been able to climb through that. That's some real good design. Inside here. Seems like a vortex. Let us enter. Julian's back in the party. Do I want Julian knows the question? Hyperion and Blowbeat. I'm just looking at the our stuff right now. Wow, so with Julian and what if I was in there? Nope. What if Setsuna was in there? Okay, so yeah, we're gonna stick to our normal setup. I'm gonna actually keep not Turno, but Setsuna here. I've been liking that, and I'm gonna be here too. So Vortex myself, we're keeping the main line going up, but now I have Setsuna. Let's give Setsuna some love, I guess. Hey, Julian, you sure it's all right for us to be here as well? If you are not with me, this shall have no meaning. After all, it is thanks to you that I am even standing here. Aw, here you are too kind, my friend. I was wondering what I wouldn't activate. I like the random encounters in this game though, actually seeing the monsters on the field. I think this is a nice touch, especially for this, set up for the classic RPG style where we can see them out there. Like, obviously, they... Well, then again, most RPGs do the palette swap anyway, so it doesn't matter. But what I mean is just seeing them out there so I can choose whether or not I want to fight them or run away. It makes it a lot easier. And plus, I do have the option of using my fog shroud thing, that item that lets me escape from battles. Antique green ring, so there's this thing down there, so there's always going to be resources in here that we can use to cook or just sell. Oh, they're so cute, their little crowns. And I love getting preemptive strikes. It's always a great thing. Oh, you're the only one. So, we got a new bunny, and we saw those penguins before, so nothing new. Besides that little bunny guy. I'm still trying to understand how the attacks work in this game. because there are some instances where I can hit multiple enemies at once, and I thought it was because it was based on the angle of how we attack, but it seems like it's more than that. Sometimes I think it's just the weapon itself. Okay, that works too. I do want to get that treasure chest. This will let me... Okay, cool. I was about to say. I want this. And we got a new chakra for you, so that's why we brought Setsuna along. Alright, cool. Is that stronger? The stronger glows in reaction to its various magical energy, increasing all attributes with the exception of physical attack power. But it just raised my attack power. I'm actually royally confused by that. It just raised my attack power. You saw it. I went back to my previous chakra. It didn't look like I got stronger. I mean, it looked like I did get though. That's some really good experience. We're close to leveling up, so I may just use a blow beat next battle. I'll try and get a preemptive strike and kill these guys as fast as possible, because I'm not dealing with that again. What's up here? Alright, cool. Damaged bronze mask. Hey, I have a mask. Turn around. There we go. Yeah, you're dying. I'm not putting up with that. I like how they just one-shots all normal enemies. There we go, that's what I needed. Thank you. And we get flux bonuses by using momentum mode. I think that's what that one tutorial meant. Oh, damn it. Oh, one for royal blood. I have a question for thee. Alright, Julian, that's for you. Huh? What was that voice? Doesn't seem like anyone's about to attack us or nothing. A question, huh? Very well. Ask your question, and I shall answer. Long ago, a peasant requested counsel with the king and told him of his hardship. The king felt pity for the peasant and bestowed upon him a gift, his own ring. The peasant thanked the king and promptly sold the ring in order to ease his financial hardship. Were the king's action just? That's the question I put today. King's the most powerful man in the country. He can't just ignore people and let them suffer. He was definitely just. I wonder. Isn't it unfair for the king himself to be giving the peasant a gift? I'm sure everyone else would have liked him to help them out, too. Alright, that's enough chatting. Please. I want you to collect your thoughts and each think of your answer. Let our minds be as one. Kira makes a good point, but then again, he could have helped. He's helping his people out. And that's usually a good thing, you know, because it shows that he's not just a king, he's also a person. It makes him more human. I honestly do want to say that he was just in helping that person out, and if there were other people there, he would have found other means to help them. I mean, would I have given a ring? Nah, I would just be like, hey, you work for me now. We got a big castle, I'm sure I can get you a job here, you and your family can just stay here, you know? But, I don't know. One who lacks decision is not fit to become king. Leave here. Damn it. And it restarted us. Okay, so... And then we have to fight these guys again. So we do have to be decisive and make an answer, alright. Now I know. At least we can get that again. Okay. I get it. Okay, Setsuna has her HP back. Because I healed her. But tell me, Is it truly that simple? It's just helping. Is it just as simple as, like, here, let me help you? There has to be more to it. Oh, stop healing. Come on, man. And stop that, too. I'm gonna go for this guy here. There we go, he's gonna call for help. You're gonna hit me with a hurricane. You're awfully so sweet for that. It was. I was feeling a cold breeze. Kinda like I needed one. Okay, good. And Setsuna's about to level up, so it's okay. Okay, now I know we have to pick answers. But I'm not even the king, so why are you... Why am I involved in this? I shouldn't have the answers. It should be just Julianne. Yeah, yeah, we know, we know. Yeah. We get it. Let's skip it. Man, it's cool that he helped it. I swear, saying he's just is wrong. There better be good reasoning behind him being just. I mean, he can't ignore his people. That's a given. He has to find a way to help them. So I'm gonna go with that. The answer is, he was just. What king can hold his head high if he cannot save a single man who stands before his very eyes? So, that is thine answer? Thou lackest insight, thou shalt continue on. That is unfair! Yo, that is unfair! You say I lack insight, so that clearly would mean that we need more context into the situation as well? His better understanding of what makes a king and whatnot, so every situation is different, so me giving you the asterisks, how is that wrong? Oh, man, you are very upsetting, game. Like, super upsetting with that. So what is he supposed to do? Just send him on his way? He has to do something. He has to find a way to help his people. Help that person. If he's poor and having financial problems, clearly there are other people that are going through the same. Die. Then again, saying he's just would be the obvious answer here, but sometimes the obvious answer is what you need to go with. But still, that's really... I better heal Setsuna before she dies. Okay, I want to see the reasoning behind why that would be unjust, because at the same time, it's kind of like, doesn't he need to help them? I mean, it's a single person. Clearly, there shouldn't be anything wrong with helping a single person, right? But, whatever. He was unjust. There is no other answer. It is understandable that faced with an impoverished man, one would wish to reach out a helping hand. For a normal man, that would be just a decision, but not for a king. And what is the reason for thine answer? The first principle of any kingdom is that its people must not starve. Thus, the harvesting of crops forms the backbone of any country. If there are peasants suffering, that is clear evidence that the king's rule is not working effectively. If he considers immediate charity as acceptable redress for the greater follies of his rule, then he has no right to be king. A just king should not give charity to the few. He should rule in a way that benefits the many. Instead of giving charity to a peasant, the king should gather his retainers and fulfill his duty to the people by implementing a new, more just rule. Okay, I get it now, I get it. Thou hast answered well. A virtuous man may help one person, but a virtuous king grants favor to all his people. No king must allow his people to live in hardship. Engrave these words upon thy heart and continue on. Thank you! Is there items up here? I guess this is just a shortcut. Okay, yeah, that's just a shortcut, so let's keep going. Huh. Alright. Yeah, I don't feel like fighting you guys. Do we want to switch that? No, we don't. Not yet. Okay, maybe we do. What's down here? Yeah, we do. There we go. I guess we just switch that back. Yeah, we'll have to switch it back. Can you move? Just kill them all like this. It seems like we have a new snake enemy, so that's pretty interesting. Looks like you lived. I'll let Setsuna handle them. I'll go for this guy over here. Alright, Setsuna, do your thing. I like that though, how we can just wear Chakram's throne. It's pretty interesting. But look at the time. I'm gonna wrap things up here. I hope all of you enjoyed. Thank you for joining me for another episode. I am Setsuna. The next time we do this, we're just gonna keep exploring these ruins. So be sure to like this video, share with all of your friends. I appreciate the love and support that you send my way. Drop a comment down below. Let me know your thoughts, comments, concerns, whatever you got for me. Whatever you got, just drop it down there. If you're new around here, what are you doing? What are you doing? We like to have fun around here, so you know the drill. Subscribe. I bid you all adieu. Thank you. Come again.